think that she's hurt more goalies in the entire league than any other player. As a defenseman coming down against you, who would you say is the toughest player to stop? Besides Maddie Philippe-Plain. Let's leave her out of it because she already threw one of your players under the bus, so yeah.
I was going to say Mary's easy, but... other than Mary being easy, I think that probably Rebecca Johnson, because she's so fast. You just never know, like, is she going to dangle you? Is she just going to skate by you? Like, what is she going to do?
I would suggest that she's going to come down the wing, cut to the middle, and shoot. That's, I mean, anybody else think that she's going to do that most of the time? No?
Middle, toe drag, go right. Outside, then toe drag you. I don't, you know, you just never know.
Yeah, I say it like she didn't score 1,000 goals against me, right? Like, yeah, she's pretty good. Anybody else that you would pick out of a hat?
Mary Phillip.
I guess she's an okay player. Okay, well, thank you very much. One of the best defensemen, one of the hardest shots in the league. I would say that if I was ranking the shots, I would probably put Kathy Chartrand right up there. I mean, that girl can shoot. You don't even see the puck when it's coming at you, but Courtney Brichard is right there behind her. So let's start with the next couple selections here. So we have some colors on the sticks, if you guys can see them. So we have red, white. Oh, wait, just pick Caitlin Gosling. Oh, let's put that right back in there, okay? We have blue, we have white, we have red. I think white obviously looks like it's going to be goalies. Red is defenseman, and blue is forward. So, captains, you guys can pick in any order that you want to pick. We'll just go back and forth. As the player is selected, you'll have to pick your side. That you make sure you go to the right side, come up, you'll get your jersey. Once again, Jamie and Lauren, aren't they doing an amazing job back there? You'll get your jersey from them. You'll take a picture right here in the middle. And as that's happening, I will be interviewing some of the players. So be ready with your answers. All right, can I have Carly Campbell up for the first selection? We have Jocelyn LaRocque. From the Brampton Thunder, also from Winnipeg, Manitoba. Shout out to Manitoba. I totally photobombed that one. All right, Spooner and Mick, you guys can go up and make the next selection. And Sophie, I have a question for you while they're making that selection. If you could play on any other team besides Les Canadiens de Montréal, who would you play for and why?
That's a good question. I guess I'll say Calgary because they picked me today.
What about this one right here, the Toronto Furies?
Well, I do have the season in Calgary and then half the season in Toronto. Yeah.
I like that selection. Nice. Oh, you guys went with a goalie selection? From the Brampton Thunder, sticking with the theme, Erica Howe. Erica Howe might have been selected as the best dressed for the evening. I like the suspenders. And the red socks. Posing for the next cover in McLean's. Carly Campbell, come up, make your next selection. Oh, who could this possibly be? I'm gonna take a wild guess. Sammy Joe Small is selected. Thank you. Top vote getter. Thank you. Charlie, just have a seat. No big deal. This goaltender, four-time Olympic gold medalist. So I guess you got a kind of a good pick there. One of the best goalies to have ever played the game. Not only is she a talented goaltender, but gives back so much to the game. You can make your way up here, or would you like me to keep introducing? Yeah. I could say more nice things about you. One of the captains on the team last year you were the captain?
Yeah.
2 years ago. And probably one of the best photo ops in women's hockey was her taking the opening faceoff and winning the opening faceoff as a goaltender. Charlie, you get your stick. You get to keep your mini stick. That's part of the deal is we spend a lot of money on our players here in the CWHL. You get a $2 mini stick that you get to go home with. Sticking with the theme from the Brampton Thunder, Jamie Lee Rattray. Now, I have to say that I saw Jamie come into the Toronto Fury's dressing room on Wednesday with a large coffee from Starbucks for Natalie Spooner. So I think this might be a little fix. From Team White, our next selection.
No peeking.
From Les Canadiens de Montréal, Sarah Lafarre. Now, I don't know too much about Sarah, except for she is in her first year with Les Canadiens de Montréal and made the All-Star team, which is incredible. An incredible player to watch. She definitely is going to be in this league for a long time to come. And Sarah, you get your mini stick. You're not allowed to talk about who you're going to pick when it's just out of a hat here. From the Boston Blades, Tara Watchhorn. Local product from Newcastle.
They grew up playing with her.
And Natalie Spooner grew up playing with her, apparently. Pretty impressive. For a few years. Now, I have to say something really nice about Tara. The Boston Blades this year went through a little bit of a rebuild, we'll say. But Tara Watchhorn is really the reason that there is a team in Boston. She's the reason that, and she gets her mini stick. Yeah, make sure she leaves with that. Talk about players giving back to the game. She has been that captain. She has been the reason that a lot of players want to play there. And it's just impressive what you do for the CWHL. So thank you, Tara Watchhorn. Next selection goes to Carly Campbell, who is going to be on Team White. This player is one of the leading point getters currently in the CWHL, which is impressive when you have so many amazing players. From the Brampton Thunder, Jess Jones. Here for one of our best players that we have in the CWHL, not only on the ice but off the ice. So, Caroline Ouellette, can you stand up for a sec? Come on over here. So, Kato is tied right now for all-time ever points in, I think, all of women's hockey ever in the history of the world. Is that something like that, right? Probably. Her dad thinks that. If you've ever been to a Les Canadiens game, that is correct. He still talks to me when I go to the games about Jillian Apps and how she's tough to play against.
I didn't like where that was going.
Okay, I want you to tell us, you've been in the league since its inception, and even before that. What changes and what positive things have you seen the CWHL go through in the 10 years that we've been around?
Well, I think thank you. How many minutes do I have? Just the caliber of play is incredible now. Every game, it's a battle. And I think this year especially, there's so much young talent that has entered the league that I'm like, wow, the future of female hockey is in great hands. And for us, Les Canadiens, the rebranding has been great, growing our fan base, and I think we have a wonderful GM. Thank you, Meg. She's here. She's amazing. She's surrounded herself with incredible staff. A lot of those women are here tonight. And, you know, the last home games that we've had, we basically played in front of packed arenas, and that never used to happen. So that's certainly a great feeling, and it's a testament to how much our game is growing and continues to do so.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Kato. The reason that the game grows is because of players like her. Laura Fortino, can you come up here for just 1 second? Another player that, incredible player. I've got a chance to practice with Fortino a couple times, and you don't really appreciate her until she's on your team as a goaltender. The little things that you do is just incredible. I wanted you to tell us what kind of things the Brampton Thunder this year have done to really make an impact in the community. What you guys, as players, are trying to build here in the CWHL.
Yeah, I think with Brampton, you know, the group that we have is absolutely unbelievable. From girls on the national program to girls that are not part of the program. Like I said on Breakfast Television, they're so dedicated, and the passion they bring to the game is outstanding. And like I said, I thank them for everything that they give, because they make coming to the rink easy and they make it fun. And you know, to our GM Lori also and Chelsea, who's here, they put in such tremendous work. And The team that we're building, the organization that we have there, is growing every single year, and it's so fun to play there. And we're a passionate team, and you know, we're hoping to really go far this year with the team that we have, and I'm excited for the next couple weeks.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Laura. All right, next selection goes to Team Blue. Now we're going to say all the Toronto Furies, another rookie on defense, incredibly quick. Montreal, Cassandra Poudrier. So clearly she's a rookie because she still has her land. From the from the Spooner lent Kelly Terry. Team White. Teammate, right. Oh, I'm so sorry, but you're not going to be last. While they're night. What would you like to say to your players in advance of the game?
So they'll be in bed in half an hour.
Tessa, you want to step out of the shadows over there? Tomorrow's going to be pretty intense. Do you have anything up your sleeve for the game?
Well, Sammy, I'm smarter to know not to divulge information on stage when other coaches and players are there, but I had an opportunity to play in one of these All-Star games, and it was a time of my life. I feel like the crowd was amazing. It was so much fun to play with other talented players. Like the girls have said, that usually you're used to going head-to-head with, so it's nice to get a little bit of a break and not have yourself be beat up on or beat up on anyone else. So I think it should be a great outcome, a fun time. Becky and I are going to stay up really late tonight, obviously going over our playbook. And we'll let these girls know in the morning what we expect of them. And obviously the W, our captain mentioned, is pretty much guaranteed. Yes.
Thank you. And good luck to both teams. We still have two more selections to make here. So we have two players that have been waiting incredibly patiently. So it's never easy to be selected last. It's different when the players are actually selecting you, and then you're kind of last and nobody wanted you on your team. That's not the same as these two guys, but because of your patience, because of the fact that you waited all night, I just wanted to tell you that both of you guys are going to be receiving a spa day. It says, of your choice. Of your choice. I don't know what that means. Does that mean you can travel to St. Moritz, Switzerland, and have yourself a spa day there? I don't know. You'll have to talk to Brenda about that. But it says, final two players get a spa day of your choice. That's on air right there. So congratulations to both of you guys. And if captains could come up and make your final selections. Thank you. luck to all the players, and may the best team win. Okay, first we're gonna do team selfies, and then we're gonna do a big team picture together.
Congratulations on coming into Hockey Canada Foundation. I love that.